side of the microphone.
And on this side, it's Peggy Pico.
And you're tuned to the award-winning sound of KCR College Radio.
And we want you to listen every Sunday morning with me and Brother Jay.
Of course, we have great stuff for you, like phone calls, special guests in studio, and, of course, always the great music right here.
And music trivia by Bro John himself.
I try.
And you can listen to us at KCR College Radio, AM 1610 on SESU, award-winning Sound of State.
Bored during the day? Maybe you just want to chat. Drop us a line, 619-594-6982. 'Cause you had a bad day. Turn it up with KCR. Sing a sad song
just to turn it around. Live from the San Diego State University studios, KCR College Radio is on the air for the home of the Aztecs.
If you think you know San Diego State, you gotta check out KCR. News, sports, entertainment, and of course, music. Turn it up with KCR.
This is KCR, the Sound of State.
Last night, you cried. I didn't know what to do. Seems like you tried. Now I'm trying to understand how you are. Soon we'll be far apart. Myself into. Tell me how to live. Tell me how to stay. Tell me how to hold back all of me. Tell me where you go. Will you be okay? Tell me that you're coming back. Coming. Tell me how to live. Tell me how to live.
My breath is getting short. I don't know anymore. I want to be the one, I hope I can. 'Cause maybe it's so hard to breathe, and all I ever want to be is something that you see as free, and one day show the light in me. And all I want to know is where to go when things get slow, and when I'm alone, you're the one I want the most.
Tell me how to live. Tell me how to stay. Tell me how to hold back all of me. Tell me where you go. Will you be okay? Tell me that you're coming back. Coming back. Tell me how to live.
Thank you. I can't hear any music in my headphones.
Can you hear me?
Not on my headphones.
Oh, wait. Can you hear me, though? Oh, wait. Is your volume up?
Ah, there it is.
Yeah. All right, perfect. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Hey, guys. This is All Ears on Lee. I'm your host, DJ Christian Lee. This is my show. We're doing another segment of Undiscovered Firsts, where we bring you some of the hottest music from San Diego. And coincidentally, we have someone from SD right now. And who are you?
Hey, what's happening? It's Yandi.
Perfect.
How y'all doing? Thank you, Christian, for having me. This is sick.
Yeah, love no, this is awesome. Yandi, he's a rapper. He went to Chico. He had a group there. Now he's back. He's still doing some hot tracks.
Yeah, I try to keep him hot, you know.
I know you do. All right, give me one second. But yeah, how are you doing today?
Oh, man, I'm doing great. It's a beautiful day. This is the first time I've ever been down on the SDSU campus.
Wait, really?
Yeah. Dang. I've never been here. Like, it's so beautiful. Like, it's crazy.
Yeah, no.
And, like, I'm sorry. Here. Like, everything about here is beautiful. You know, the people, like, the trees, everything.
I mean,
with SD, well, like, San Diego, I don't really expect anything less, you know?
That's true.
Yeah.
All right, here. Yeah, I got some questions for you, Yandi.
Oh,
you know,
sweet.
So you're from Texas, right? That's where you were born?
Yeah, that's where I was born, in Houston.
Yeah, and then you moved to San Diego. And
Moved. I lived in Texas for a little bit, like not too long, maybe like 3 or 4 years. And then I moved to Oklahoma, maybe a year or two. I don't really remember too much. All I remember is playing like Mortal Kombat and the Sega in Oklahoma and like huge-ass thunderstorms, dude. Like crazy ones. And then I moved to San Jose, and then when I was about 8, I moved down to San Diego. Yeah,
That's awesome. And so my question for you is it's a question I ask like everyone's like, where's the best place to get a Cali burrito?
Shit, come on. Oh, in San Diego?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
I'd probably say PB. I was on the beach, and you know, you don't really think about like, oh, I have to go to this place. You kind of pick like the most like not really rundown place, but I guess the most traditional. Or, you know, the sign is like kind of half lit. Yeah, the sign's half lit. You know, this burrito is going to be dank.
I know. But you don't have any like specific place in mind?
My go-to up in Carlsbad is probably Mexico Viejo or Alejandro's. That goes hard. Or Roberto's, dude. I love Roberto's.
Yeah. Anything that ends with like toes. That place is pretty prime.
Yeah, Armando's.
Roberto's.
Yeah, Alberto's. Yeah. It's all good.
All right. And so I have another question for you, too. And so how did you get into rapping?
I've always kind of been a music head, you know. Yeah. My mom always listened to a lot of rap, like Tupac.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like all of them. My dad used to listen to a lot of hip rap, like the Ghetto Boys from Houston. Yeah,
classic.
Yeah, Eminem. Like, I remember spitting Eminem and not knowing like what half the words meant, but I knew them, you know.
Yeah.
And then when I was 15, I started writing some parodies with my friends, and after that I got to college and I started taking a little more seriously, you know. I actually feel like I had like a talent and a skill, so then I started going hard, and then here I am. You know?
Nice, yeah.
Yeah,
it's been a journey.
Yeah, I mean, it's been hard, dude. I've been working. Still so long to go, man. It's crazy.
Hey, you're still on that grind.
Yeah, that's what it feels like.
All right. My follow-up for that is, you know, you listened, your mom and dad, they showed you, like, a lot of rap, hip-hop, and everything. Mm-hmm. But what was, like, the song when you were a kid that made you, like, you know what? I want to be a rapper.
Song? Which song?
Is there anyone that, like, any song that pops up in, like,
your mind? I got an album. Definitely. Actually, there's a couple. There's 50 Cent's Get Rich or Die Trying.
Like, that's a classic one.
Yeah, Many Men, Wish Death Upon Me. Oh, yeah, that one's sweet. And then the Eminem Show. Bro, that whole album just, like, got me. Like, I don't know why that one song, I can't explain it. I think my dad's gone crazy. You know which one I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, dude, that one's crazy. I love that. I love the story behind that track, too. It's because Eminem, I told Kim that he was going to take Haley to Chuck E. Cheese, but he took her to the studio instead. I'm like, all right. Hey, you got to do what you got to do.
Was that Haley's song?
Yeah, that's Haley's song. Haley's song.
Perfect. Yeah.
Like, Daddy, what are you doing? Okay, then. Oh, yeah, that's great.
Wait, do we have Eminem in the studio right now? What? Dude, that's cool. Yeah, man. Dude, Eminem, he was such a storyteller back in the day.
Yeah, dude, he goes hard. I love his style. Like, it's so aggressive, but it's so clean at the same time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're right. All right.
Dude, Eminem just came out with he finished a new album, too.
Wait, really?
He didn't come out yet, but okay. he finished a new one, yeah.
Real talk, though. How do you feel about, like, his latest albums, though?
Dude, I mean, in my eyes, like, Eminem has done it. Like, he's done it.
He's a legend, yeah.
You know, he's a legend. Like, I think, you know, he kind of changed his style. Now he's literally just talking like this and talking the real, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it's just like, all right, like, I'm still going to listen to you because now you're just talking. Like, you've been just talking, but now, like, you're literally just saying, like, telling it how it is. And I'm down for that, you know?
I don't know. Ever since he did that collab album with, like, Royce da 5'9",
he's like, dude.
It's a crazy album, which was great.
Yeah.
But then, like,
Bad Meets Evil.
Yeah, he switched up his flow, though. Now, like, every song you hear him rap, it sounds like he's just angry, you know?
Oh, yeah, dude, he's pissed. I think he's just over the world.
Yeah,
like, he's
maybe.
Just over it. Like, he's over, I bet he's over how music's going. Like, I bet he turns on the radio. It doesn't even turn on the radio. But when he does, he's like, what is this? You know? It's like, yeah. It's sad.
It is crazy. But you know what? Enough about Eminem, you know? Let's talk more about you. But actually, you know what? Let's play one of your songs first.
Oh, sweet.
All right, you know what? Let's play this song. It's the All Get Right remix.
Oh, that's an old one.
That's a trippy one, but that was a good one too. We're going to play that and we'll be right back, guys.
All right.
Tell me that I'm hot, but I feel ice cold. Oh, I never thought this would ever get old. But she the only one getting down at my shows. Afterwards, say some words, get the crew and rock and roll.
We do this like every night. Seem like all we do is fight. Then we can scratch and bite, just so we can feel alright. Oh, that's right, you got him. Someone you think understands. Run your mouth, let them know exactly what we shout about. This ain't new, what you do. You should know that ain't cool.
Where is your head? Tell me your thoughts. Don't you go tell me I'm crazy, I'm not. This you've been on, I can't put in words. Just to be simple, it's absurd. Feeling you put in me got me depressed. Holding my chest, that's why I left. That's why you're gone.
Don't touch my patience, I'm just saying. You were the master in disguise. So I think it's time for extreme makeovers. No need to waste no time like you wasted mine. Oh no, for real though.
Tell me that I'm hot, but I feel ice cold. Oh, I never thought this would ever get old. But she the only one getting down at my shows. Afterwards, say some words, get the crew and rock and roll.
Hey, we're back, guys. This is KCR College Radio, and I'm here with my guest, Yandi.
What up?
And yeah, thanks for coming on, man. I appreciate it.
Thank you for having me, Christian. You're the man.
Yeah, I know, man. I know. But
okay.
But you know, I told everyone last week too, but I'll tell them again, even though it did pass. Like, you had your show at House of Blues. You know, how was that?
Oh, dude, it was like nothing I've ever done. You know,
was it your first time there?
Yeah, first time ever performing there. And it's always been a dream of mine, you know. You hear about it all the time. You go to shows there, and it's just like, damn.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I hope I can touch this stage just like everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and it's like sitting in the green room, you know, you just think of all the people that sat exactly where you're sitting. It's just like, I'm here right now.
That's
like,
true, yeah.
I'm here. Like, this is insane. Like, this is cool. Like, you know, it's something special.
No, very, very. And you know, you just did that show. Do you have any other shows lined up too in the future?
Right now, I'm really focusing on just getting some new content going. You know, just I've been trying to get like the social presence a little like online a little harder. But you know, I'm still looking for shows. You know, I'm trying to get involved a little bit more in the community down here after being down up in Chico. It's kind of you know, I have to get my feeding back here, but it's all good. I know there's going to be shows, and it's not something I really worry about too much, you know, but I'm just trying to build my resume and keep going, keep the momentum up.
I know there's some artists, too. They just go, like, on the grind of shows. You know, I've spoke to some people. They've done, like, 15 to 20 shows in, like, 1 month, you know?
Yeah.
Would you ever consider doing that, too?
Oh, dude, that's a dream. Like, I want to do all I want to do are shows. You know, I want to have to work on music on a bus or in a van because, you know, that's the only time I have. It's just like, it's that, I don't know, it's just that, like, that energy of always grinding, you know, and always performing. I love performing. Like, there's nothing else like it. There's really not, like, you know, to see out there, look at the people, like, jamming their heads, doing whatever, smiling, like, yeah, you're doing great, yeah, give them high fives. But, like, the real, like, gift is, you know, afterwards, I don't care if it's 100 or one person that comes up to me and is like, hey, that was so dope. Like, keep doing what you're doing. You know, like, I loved everything you were talking about. I loved your message. I was really listening. Like, thank you. And I'm just like, oh my God, you're welcome. You're so welcome. But, you know, I got to keep it all cool on the outside. I'm like, oh, thanks, man. Like, yeah. Follow me on social. All right, yeah. Uh-huh. No, I was kidding. Kind of.
Hey, that's great to have people like that, though.
Hey, dude, that's what really drives me. And it's like, that's all I need to, like, keep this going. You know, it's like, that's what I'm going for. I want to connect people. You know, I want people to, like, know that, you know, if they're feeling sad or heartbroken or anything, angry, like, you know, you're not the only one feeling like this, you know, because that's something I feel like a lot of people feel, you know, especially something like depression. You know, you just feel alone, even when, like, you have, you know, however many people in your house or how many people saying I love you. It's just, you know, you feel like no one else can feel the way you feel. You know, so I really wanted to be able to speak a message and, like, tell everyone, like, hey, it's okay. Like, I felt like this too, you know? what happened is, like, it's human. Like, don't feel like it's you're the only one in this world. You know,
that's a great thing about music too. It's just, you know, helps you like project, like lets you speak to everyone too.
Oh, dude,
it makes it so relatable.
It's beautiful. That's a beautiful thing about music. It's so fluid and so diverse. Like, it's for everyone.
Yeah,
like, it's awesome.
Okay, and so believe it or not, you know, so you went to Chico State, right?
I did.
And you actually did radio
there
too.
Shout out Chico. Yep. Shout out Soda, by the way, too. Y'all are dope. But yeah, I had a show there for with Underhouse. It was called Under the House Radio. And I went by the DJ name of Pool Boy.
And so how'd you get that name?
Keeping your mom company while you're at school.
Ah, okay. I see.
Yeah, you know, it was cool. It was fun. It was a great time. I interviewed artists. You know, I had Jay Supreme up there.
Yeah.
You know, I had the homies. I had some producers. It was great. You know, I had a turned up karaoke.
You did?
Yeah. That was so crazy. I was just going off like in the studio by myself. Just going crazy, singing like Migos and like DJ Carnage and stuff, just BS, you know. That was so much fun. I loved it. It was so much fun.
Yeah, that sounds like a trip. And speaking of Underhouse too, you know, so how did you form Underhouse? Because that, for people who don't know, Underhouse was this group he made up in Chico.
Yeah. So Underhouse just kind of came together. You know, I saw a lot of my friends and bands and stuff, and you know, when you're in a band, it's powerful. You know, you have 4 to 5 members or 2 to 5 members, and it just more than one, and it like extends their network a little bit. You know, it breaks the web open and it really expands everything. So I thought, you know, I'm in this college town. You know, I kind of know people, but I don't think I know enough people. You know, so I'm like, okay, well, let's gather a collective of people who want to do what I want to do too. You know, and who are the same like creative mindset and art and music or whatever, filming, drawing, everything, and create this, our own quote band, you know, and Underhouse came out of that. You know, I came up with Underhouse because I made it under my basement too.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah. And then, you know, it just kind of formed into this like awesome movement, you know, it really came down, you know, I try to really think about what I loved most about it and was really so rewarding, I think, was being able to provide all these opportunities for artists who just didn't have the same opportunity. You know, like I was able to get their songs recorded or give them tracks to write songs to, or, you know, and then be able to have a show at the end of the month to go show off that. Like, it's so like great. It's so rewarding. You know, I loved that. I loved it so much. It was a lot of work, but you know, it really made it worth it at the end of the day.
Yeah, no, I bet.
And I'm really hoping to like do that down here too, you know?
I was going to ask you. Yeah.
I'm
like, would you
think, you know, it's, the first time Underhouse, I presented, I guess you can say, like Underhouse to the public.
Yeah.
Was after I won this like Battle of the Bands thing at Chico. And I'm like, all right, well, I could take this show, or I'd be like, hey, I have this other thing here, Underhouse. Bah. Mm. And so what I kind of realized I have to do is, you know, I have to grind. I have to grind myself. And if I want to bring these other people up, I know, one, they're grinding, but two, I know I have to grind hard if I want to make, like, give the same opportunity to everybody else, you know?
Yeah.
And it's like, I'm not saying that these people can't do without me, my friends can't do without me, everyone's in the collective can't do without me, because they can. Anybody can do without anybody else. It's simple, you know, but it's kind of nice to have this, not really weight, but, like, a nice pressure on, you know, because okay. I want to be able to provide these opportunities for people, you know. You know, I got the House of Blues gig, and immediately I'm like, all right, I have to have Jason, like Jay Supreme, like he has to be there.
Uh-huh.
You know, because he's my day one homie. Like, bro, I've been friends with him for like 14 years.
Dang.
And like, I had to have him there, you know.
Yeah.
And it was sick, and it felt so good to be able to bring him with me, you know. It's so rewarding. Like,
it is.
There's nothing like it, dude. Like, I'm wrapping up there with my best friend on one of the best moments of my life. You know, if I can keep doing that with people and for people, you know, it's so rewarding.
That's what I like about you, man. You know, because I know there's a bunch of artists, you know, like once they blow up or they're trying to do the thing, people they started with, you know, they just forget about them. Mm-hmm. But you know, you still have the crew together. You still remember your day ones, you know, you're helping bring them up too.
Hey,
I
know,
respect that.
You know, I'm trying, you know, and, you know, I realize that, like, you know, you can only really bring people up who want to be there too.
Yeah.
You know, that's definitely been probably one of the hardships of, you know, kind of growing and everything, just life in general. You know, it's like you want to keep bringing people up, but at the same time, if they're not putting the effort in that, like, you know, that they would do if you weren't there, then it's like, man, I can't keep doing this for you.
Sure. Yeah.
And, you know, it hurts sometimes, but, you know, it's what it is. And everyone understands, you know, it's good. But yeah, you know, I try if you try.
Yeah, no, that's the thing about music too. You know, like, it's great if you're doing your thing, you know, you're mm-hmm. talented, but if you don't put in your weight, you know, they got to cut you off.
Come on,
yeah, like,
you know,
music's part, like, it's partly a business too, you know?
Yeah, no, it totally is. And it's, yeah, it really is. And thank you goes a long way. To anybody who's listening, thank you, please, everything. Just thank you goes so far in my eyes. Like, if you tell me thank you, like, once, I'm just like, bro, you're so welcome. Thank you for, like, acknowledging that. Like, you know, it goes so far. Like, if you guys take anything from this, from listening to this, say thank you. That's it. Remember who, just say thank you.
Yeah, that's a great message right there. And I have one last question before we'll play more of your music. And so, you know, you formed Underhouse. And I remember during that time, you know, you had jackets, you had hoodies, you had shirts, you know.
Yeah.
You had a bunch of stuff. And then what you're doing now, too, it's like you're a little bit like an entrepreneur, you know.
Oh, yeah.
I would say.
And oh, yeah.
So my question is, you know, you actually raised money to do an Underhouse Music Fest.
Yeah.
Up in Chico, which I think is crazy. How did that happen?
Oh, man. How did you
come up with the idea to, like, get your own music fest for that?
Well, I wanted, you know, I wanted to do one last show to really bring it all, like, together. You know, it was my last year. You know, I had 2 months of school left. And I just thought, you know, what can I do to really, like, one, utilize my education, you know, in the music industry, and two, like, really make something memorable, you know, and something that I've never done. Like, well, I got to do the music festival. I have to.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, so I found the venue, you know, Delta Psi, and they have this huge yard, and it was sweet. It was cool. I got in touch with some artists from Oregon who were trying to go through California for a tour. I'm like, oh, bro, you have to be here. This is going to be sweet. You know, Cesar Chavez weekend, so I had to make it big, you know? I had to make it bigger than everything else. And it's just like, I'm like, all right, I'm going to do this. Like, I'm going to do it. You know, I started laying it all out. And my woman, she's an event coordinator. So, you know, I always, like, I laid it out, and I'd be like, hey, can you check this? She's like, yeah, you need this, this, and this, and this. I'm like, okay, bye. And I'll be right back. But it was a lot of work, man. It was probably some of the most work I've ever put into a show. And, you know, I did a crowdfunding, you know, I didn't have to pay for anything.
Yeah, no, I saw.
Bro, that was the craziest thing. I raised like over $1,000, you know, people were so supportive, you know, and people were hyped. You know, we sold out the second half with, you know, we still let people in because who cares? We had to. And, you know, it was a crazy night. It was something I'll remember for the rest of my life. And it was unlike anything I've ever experienced from that point, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's it. Bro,
that's
it was
such a wild story.
It was crazy. Like, like, oh, God, so much work put into that. Like, oh,
yeah, no,
I
impressive.
Love it. I love grinding. Like, I love having to challenge myself, you know? So great.
Yeah, that's what I like to hear in artists, you know? They love the challenge. They're up for it.
Yeah, like, if everything's too easy, it's not worth it, you know?
Exactly.
That's why I can't play, like, any video games on super easy. It's boring. It's a waste of my time.
It is. It's true.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we'll be back, guys, but we're going to play some of Yandi's music. But before we do that, you know, we have some ads to do too. And, you know, Yandi, he's from San Diego, you know. He loves Mexican food.
I do.
Hey, have you ever had a burrito made out of quesadilla?
Oh, quesarito? You know I have.
Ooh.
You well, know I have.
Well, you're in for a treat too, because nearby on SCSU, we have Trujillo's. Exactly.
I know I'm going after. Dude, I was literally like driving down here. I'm like, what am I going to eat after?
Maybe you are there then. SCSU students say Trujillo is the best Mexican food in the area. Maybe Yandi will find out too. Let's see if he agrees.
Well,
let's open up most waking hours. So maybe after the show, he'll get some. Maybe you'll see him there too. You get his autograph.
I'm there.
You'll know what could happen.
Hey, buy me a burrito. It'll be fun.
Yeah, that'd be great. You get a picture, get a burrito. It'll be great. And also, South Campus Plaza is brand new this year. Check out all the new stores and restaurants we got, from Trader Joe's to Pokey's. We have Broken Yolk. You know, everyone loves that place. It's coming up. It's coming up soon. Wings and Things, an iconic restaurant for San Diego. Mm. That's on the come up too. It's going to be there. And right now we also have Eureka. That's a burger place. It's a little bougie, but it's great, you know. You could find all of that there at Southwest Plaza. And with on that note, we'll be back, guys. You know what? I'll play Beta Love.
Ooh.
And we'll be back soon after a few tunes, you know.
Sweet.
Sort of way and showing up in funny ways, and every minute, any day, any person on the planet, feel it. Let me hear you say, love, love, love what it does. Puts a smile on my face just because I love me, I love you. Love having someone else to give it all to. First, love me, and two, you love you. And it all seems to work out when we love ourselves, and it's true. Happiness is something new when the days are feeling blue. Try to smile at the mirror thinking you'll enjoy the view. Brought my fire back to this life. Who knew one summer would get me on track? Now I'm back north and I feel like ain't nothing gonna hold me back from doing whatever, whenever, wherever. I lifted the weight and I lowered the pressure. You salty and pepper. Ain't no reason, please do not be so ashamed that this is your guilty pleasure. I get it and I feel for letter word in a deal. L-O-V-E-T-O-M-E is what makes us like the real. I love, love. Someone else to give it all to. Oh, oh, I love, love.
It doesn't matter where you are in your life, you still have to, like, step back and take a breath and say, hold on a second, what's important here?
Yeah.
It's true.
It is true.
I think, yeah, life is can be really simple if you just step back and take a look at it. Be a little patient. Just stop. You get all caught up like on a merry-go-round.
Need to remember to breathe. As I stare into the sky, see the clouds behind the trees. I tend to forget how I'm free. As I listen to the sound of the leaves, enjoy the breeze, and dip both my feet into the spring. And all the rocks beneath my toes, love the rush all through my skin. And I feel the colors of my eyes finally filling in again. Yeah, been way too stressed. Thought too damn hard, had to be the best. I tried sleeping more, long smoking less, so I could bench around. Do 100 reps, I'm so unimpressed.
so sin calls my name. Till then, gotta play in a way that we pay for a day when we all here for the same thing. Oh yeah, that's me, but it's us. Come on, y'all, it's still nuts. Got three, got one, got Hennessy for my family. That's a must. Yeah, I crush all that I touch. So try not to choke on my dust. Got something to say, I'm up today. So keep your mouth shut, hush.
We still remember to breathe. Eyes are staring to the sky. See the clouds behind the trees. I tend to forget how I'm free. As I listen to the sound of the leaves, enjoy the breeze, and dip both my feet into the spring. A lot of rocks beneath my toes. Love the rush all through my skin. And I feel the colors of my eyes falling from the window. Touched on the top of my dresser. Seem like the bills never quit coming, like readings from my professor. My effort to stay afloat on top this ocean of pressure must be balanced by living out my life with minimum air. My treasures buried in sand, sweat blood from my own hand. How deaf look the reality, I can tell you where I stand. Within this industry of fakes, lay dead in the grass, snakes. I'm walking all through the fields, I'm catching y'all with my rake. And concentrated with purpose, I'm trying to turn in the quest. Compensation is worth it, not if I'm second to best. In the west of Texas, my station, but not my current location. I'm plenty far from my comfort zone. Can y'all feel that relation? The vibrations come from direction where I point my intention. Extended finger to haters, only love to those who I mention. Need to keep up with repetition, stay hard and consistent to step up in this profession. No second guessing, I know that I need to.
Need to remember to breathe. As I stare into the sky, see the clouds behind the trees. I tend to forget how I'm free. As I listen to the sound of the leaves, enjoy the breeze, and dip both my feet into the spring. A lot of rocks beneath my toes, love the rush all through my skin. And I feel the colors of my eyes falling from the rain again.
Seeing your soul, give me things that I wanted to know. Tell me things that you've done. I've been feeling old, I've been feeling cold. You're the heat that I know. Listen, you are my son.
You my energy, my stamina, model for my camera. Caesar, Cleopatra, follow you to Ethiopia. And all my guard is down, I don't need it for the night. Coming here to lay you down, make you tingle, I'm your sprite. Got the moon to my back, scratch mark, looking track. See your pitch in the black, sound gold like a plaque. With the alpha of the pack, I unleash the whole beast. And the night is for the taking, and I take you off for me, yes.
I've been seeing, oh, I've been seeing your soul. Give me things that I wanted to know. Tell me things that you've done. I've been feeling old, I've been feeling cold. You're the heat that I know. Listen, you are my son.
We know this isn't love, nothing bad at coming near it. Just a couple young souls who don't care if they're forgiven. Being shaded by the night, cover everything we live. Send it till the break of dawn, then tomorrow we'll live. If it's loving, it's original, made up from the mythical. Invisible to everyone, and thinking it's forbiddable. Yeah, we understand it's frowned upon in this society, but God made our minds, so it's longing for variety. So while I'm still living on this planet, I'ma do it, snatch or all the rest of y'all can panic. Intoxicated from this practice, yeah, I'm covered by the jacket of the never-ending night. Yeah, your body is my head.
seeing, oh, I've been seeing your soul. Give me things that I wanted to know. Tell me things that you've done. I've been feeling old, I've been feeling cold. You're the heat that I know. Listen, you are my son.
Hey, you're listening to KCR, the award-winning Sound of State. And if you didn't know, that was all Yandi tracks right there. First one was Beta Love. Second one was Relax, a collab he did with Subfer, which is great.
Shout out Subfer, killing that shit. Oh, I mean, oop.
Yeah, killing that ish, yeah. Killing that ish, yeah. And we also did, I think, what you called the track Night, right?
Yeah, I called it Night. It was a... a track by Chet Faker and Flume called Drop the Game.
Yeah.
I love that song.
Such a good song. Yeah, you want it too, it just makes it twice as better. You
know? Oh, stop it. Stop it. You know all the right things to say.
And so we'll go back to, you know, being on the radio too. We'll go back, like, how'd you get in the radio up in Chico?
The radio up in Chico, KCSC. You know, someone just told me, hey, you want to come do a radio show at KCSC? I'm like, yeah. Okay. So I went and did it. And next thing I know, I'm doing it.
That sounds exactly like how I got into KCR.
Yeah, right? Crazy. Crazy. It's pretty insane.
Yeah. All right. And so, you know, you performed at the House of Blues. Mm-hmm. Where else have you performed? In San Diego.
In San Diego? San Diego's been a little more, I guess, I don't know, selective. I performed at this bar down in North Park called the Marrow.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, that was cool. And then I performed at this venue over in North Park, too, with Underhouse called the Irenic.
The Irenic, yeah, dude, that place is crazy. I love that place.
Yeah, well, it's pretty cool. It's pretty sweet.
It's like a church, but at night it turns into a venue.
Yeah, it gets pretty crazy, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of it, though. I mean, you know, I'm looking to go perform in other places, you know. Yeah. Cough, cough. Yep. You know, I want to step into that Viejas Arena, you know, soon enough.
Yeah, you get there. Maybe you could open up for Jay-Z when he comes in.
Hey, exactly. You know, I'll call him, see what he's up to.
Yeah. Call Jay.
Yeah, you know.
Okay. And so, yeah, you performed quite a few places here. And, you know, you performed a bunch in Chico, too, right?
Yeah. I mean, I've done probably a lot of, pretty much all of my shows in Chico. Nice. You know, I've the Senator up there, the Senator Theater, it's probably the biggest one in town. Oh,
nice.
So great. It's where all the big people play. That was the first place I've ever crowd surfed.
Really?
Bro, I'm like, right when I got that show, I'm like, there's enough people, I'm doing it. I'm jumping. I don't even care. And like, it was cool. I did it, but like.
Did they catch you?
Yeah, they caught me, but like, I guess, a little bigger than everybody else.
All right.
And nobody like carried me for like a minute and a half. Well, not a minute and a half, like a second and a half. They're like, oh, shoot. You're too heavy. Oh, I'm like, all right, that's fine. Weaklings, jeez, do some push-ups.
Have you seen that video of Post Malone?
Which one?
The one where he tries to crowd surf.
No.
He jumps in the crowd, and no one catches
him. They drop him, right?
No, they just move out the way.
Oh my gosh, I'm so mad.
Yeah. And he's like, such a chill dude, but so funny. I was like, you know, he's just there, just lying on the floor. He starts rapping a little bit too, you know.
Of course, you can't let that stop you.
You can't.
Okay, no one caught me. Keep going.
Crazy, yeah, it's crazy. Yeah. But I'm glad that hasn't happened to you.
Yeah, me too.
But, you know, you've performed at a bunch of places. What would you say was, like, your favorite place to perform? Like, your most memorable performance?
Mm.
Would it be the House of Blues one, or is there one up in Chico?
House of Blues is definitely up there, you know, just because, It's so great. Yeah. You know, the light guy was on point.
And, Yeah.
Like,
they know how to do it up there.
They did. Like, there's a time that I stepped in the center of the stage and the spotlights all just shined down. I was like, in my mind, I was singing. I'm like, wow, this is so cool. Like, this part looks awesome. But, you know, probably some of the best shows was up in Chico. One couple specifically, like at the 1078 gallery, it's just art gallery up there that I was working at. And, you know, we sold it out. Like, we packed it with 250 people. And it's just like, man, that goes off. Like, you're in that big of a room or that small of a room with 250 people. It's like, it's going to be crazy. And then one show I threw in my living room right before I left Chico. Bro, there's like 50 people there maybe. But, you know, it's 50 people packed into a living room. So everyone's super close and everyone just goes crazy because the energy is so like static that everybody can't hold themselves back. Yeah, it's probably some of the craziest ones so far. Yeah.
Right. That's cool.
Yeah.
Damn, you have some memorable ones right there.
Hey, thank you. Thank you.
All right. You know what? We talked about this in the beginning of the show too, but let's bring it back. Who are some of your influences?
Some of my influences right now. Man, I love Logic.
Yeah.
I love J. Cole. You know, I like G-Eazy. I don't like what he's doing right now. But it's all right. He's making money. Like, yeah. I get it. Like, it's fine. But it's okay. I love Kanye.
Of course.
Yep. Let's see. I love Chet Faker. Like, I love Chet Faker. I like Alex Wiley, Chance the Rapper.
Oh, yeah.
I just keep going, man. I love Pusha T, dude. Pusha T is probably up there, like, in top five.
Really?
Yeah, man. I love, like, his attitude and, like, bro, he's just got this sauce that's just so, just drips. It just drips. It's so cool.
Yeah, his some of the tracks go hard, man.
Yeah, those are definitely some of the ones that are up there. Did I say Kendrick?
No.
I probably don't even have to. Kendrick, like.
It's like a given, yeah.
Bro, Kendrick is amazing. I think I've been listening to a lot of Tupac lately.
Yeah.
You know, and just there's this line, I can't say it on the radio, but the way he just comes in on this song, I'm just like, what?
Was it Hit Him Up?
No, this is one with Too Short.
Oh.
I forget the name, but bro, he just comes in just like, oh, I'm working with my diamonds. Y'all just climb charts. Oh, God, dude, it's so crazy. It's like, he just come in like that.
Yeah.
He doesn't care.
Yeah, dude, he has some crazy openers for some of his songs.
Oh, yeah, it's crazy. I love it. You hit him up.
You know, maybe you should try to do that for one of your songs too. Just say something out there and people are like, what?
I think I might. Yeah. Just trying to hook them. And
yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but you know, you got to be careful in this world today. You know, everyone's super sensitive. No, I'm just kidding. You don't have to be careful.
You know,
it's music. You can just express yourself.
Speaking about lines here, I'm going to hit you up from a quote you said. This was like back in 2010.
Oh, whoa.
All right, you ready for this?
Oh, okay.
All right, let's see if it holds up today still.
7 years ago.
All right. So, girls, just to let you know, guys can't pause Black Ops to text you back.
I say that?
Yeah. Do you still believe that?
Guys can't pause Black Ops and text you back?
To text you back.
Yes. Yes, I believe that. I'm in it. Like, I got to text you after the game. Like, sorry. You can call me. It's going to be a missed call. Like, sorry. Oh, man. Black Ops was cool.
Have you played any of the new ones?
Yeah, I played Infinite Warfare. It was cool. I don't really play too many video games nowadays. You know,
You're too busy grinding.
Yeah, I mean, you have to. But
yeah.
When I do find the time to relax my mind, I will go on Destiny 2.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I go hard on that. On PS4, my name is Yandi. That's the tag. Yeah, shout out, Destiny. But, speaking of my name is Yandi, y'all go follow that on Twitter, Instagram. All that good stuff is at my name is Yandi, all one word. Yep.
Perfect. Yep. We'll definitely mention that too before at the end of the show again.
Cool.
All right. You know what?
Cool.
It's near the end of the show. Let's take a quick break. We'll play one more song. You know what? We'll play Sandman.
One more song. Sweet.
Is that you okay with that one?
Yeah. Shout out Don Hines and Riz
out
of South Carolina.
Okay, mm-hmm. We'll play that one track and then we'll be back, guys.
Do it.
Oh no. No, 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 not tonight. Hey! Hey! Could you turn down the music? I said, shut up!
Yeah. Y'all
try to sleep, but I'm putting in the grind. Keeping you awake, hear you cursing at the baseline. Moon in the sky with the well-lit shine. Peeking in your window, hit the corner of your eye. Wolf among sheep, I ain't hidden in the high. Set the jet, I got the tinted windows on the side. Made a booth out the fly. Only took about a week, only 6 feet old. Feeling like 100 feet. Oh me, oh my, would you glance at the time? Got a meeting at my work, but I'm with the jet. I thinking quick with a text. Bad food, wanna die. What's a little wide life for 11:25? Yeah, the rate to pay me got away and making me sick. With the work I'm putting in, should be running this. Gotta quit last week, started hating on me. I ain't giving you my time if you treat it like it's free.
Hey, I swear to God, if you guys don't turn down that gun music, I am gonna call the police.
I ain't got a full night's sleep in a minute. I've been working for a check just so I can go and spend it on the same. Put me on my in the beginning, yeah, I'm talking about the end, eh? Shit, I got a whole lot of problems I ain't never find a fix for. Mother, I ain't trying to do a mix for. Ain't enough time to take a journey to the licks, though. And why the hell 12 on my 6-4? Lately, I've been stuck at home working on the tape. And maybe after this one, I'll finally get a break. I probably won't take it if I get it, cause I'm looking at my digits and they looking back with a blank face. I'ma need a meal for my mama and my little bro, too. I ain't worried about a label cause the deal won't do. I can do it on my own cause I started off alone, not a city with the whole crew. I'm the only motherfucker working 50 plus hours. Come home, hit the stool before I take a shower. I don't waste time, I'm forever on the ground. Cause the game don't stop, now the whole thing's ours. You know, you know.
Man, the only way to get it is to prove that I'm committed. So I'm giving up my sanity to show I'm truly with it. Keep the Z's, I ain't sleeping till I feel it, finally get it. Keep the dreams, don't hear me talk about it till I did it. San Diego got a funny way of trying to turn me down. Bunch of prima donna artists really think they run the town. This is anybody's city, ain't nobody got the crown. Y'all my fam, not my foes, but I can turn this shit around. Weight up on my chest ever since I graduated. So familiar with the pressure back when I was educated. So I slowed up on my smoking and I started meditating. Found my inner strength and now I got the time to demonstrate it. Bitch, watch, I'ma turn it up a notch. Colonel in the pot, who you know is about to pop. Hear the bass when it slap, yeah, the 808 drop. I'm the beast, not the bad, let you know you can't stop. Wake up!
Boom, boom. Every time. God, you gotta give me a warning.
Sorry, man, dude, I just got cut off quick. So this is KCR College Radio, AM 1610, San Diego. And that was Sandman. And great sample, by the way. Who produced that? Was that you?
808 Jedi. Ooh. 808 Jedi. He's like, hey, you should listen to this. It took me like 10 minutes. It just blew me away, man. I'm like, all right, let's do this. Like, it has to be done. Man, he goes hard. He just keeps on sending all these bangers. He's like, hey, what do you think about this? It's cool. Shout out 808 in Orange County. Man, you're doing the most.
Yeah, I agree. I agree.
Yes, I concur.
Okay, let's get serious for a second, though. All right. So you're a songwriter, you're a rapper. Anything else you do?
You know, I do graphic design. You know, I edit videos. I shoot.
Oh, really?
Some videos when I have. Yeah, I edit my own stuff. You know, and edit when it comes up. I'm not a master at that, but you know, it's like you watch a tutorial, like just do it, and you learn how to do it.
It's amazing what YouTube could do, man.
Yeah, man, it's crazy. Right. You know, it's I work out. I don't know.
Yeah. You're like, inside tip right now. Do you edit Don's videos or does he do it himself?
No. He does his own. It's just like, it's kind of like he doesn't, you don't really want someone else editing your music because you have this vision and you want to be able to like fully like express your vision before someone else kind of touches it, you know? Mm-hmm. And plus, Don doesn't want me touching stuff. He just started letting me use his camera, so. You know.
Okay. Dang.
Yeah. No, it's cool though.
Hey, and I noticed too, I guess, I don't know if it's his room or not, but I saw there's like a sound booth. Is that your room or?
Oh yeah, it's a studio I built.
Oh really?
Yeah, I built the this studio in my parents' little garage. Yeah, and it's sweet. I mean, it turned out cool. I built like a 7-foot tall.
I've seen in the background of some of his videos.
Oh yeah, thanks man. Yeah, 7-foot tall like recording booth out of PVC pipe and some plywood. You know, I built it 7 feet tall for Don because he's 6'5". He's 6'5 or 6'6". And
I didn't know he's that tall, dang.
He doesn't even use it. Like I can't believe that. Mother ducker. Jeez. Crazy. No, but I love it, dude.
Do you use it a lot too, though?
Oh, yeah. I use it every day.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I have to.
Every day grinding.
I had to have it.
Well, before we move on to another question about you, how did you link up with Don, you know?
I met Don through Jay Supreme.
Oh. Okay.
And Don had come, I don't know, had come and recorded us at the Studio West down in RB, I think, or up in RB. Like one random day. And then, you know, we started hanging out and he came a New Year's party. That was cool. And then we started talking like, yo, you want to move in? He's like, yeah. Okay, cool.
Wow.
Yeah.
Let's go straightforward. Dang.
Yeah, man.
Okay. And so, you know, you've done a lot of stuff in the past, but let's talk about the future. So what do you have planned in the future?
World domination. You know, I'm really hoping to keep expanding my career, you know, really progressing. You know, that's the main thing. That's the main goal is just progression. You know, I want to be able to put out more music. I want to build a bigger audience. I want to connect to more people. You know, I want to do shows at bigger venues. I want to go on tour. I want to be on tour by next summer.
Really?
Yeah. Like that's definitely a goal I'm working towards. And that's why I'm trying to work so hard to build up this cult following, you know, so I could go present it to a big name artist and be like, hey, like, I know I can guarantee you 100 to 200, 300 people can come out to the show, like, to see it, to see me, you know, like, put me on your tour, please. Like, God.
Yeah,
man, that's kind of the plan right now.
Yeah. All right. And just let me get this out of the way before we have to do other stuff. So catch The Sound of State on air and on campus on AM 1610, online at kcrlive.com, or download the free TuneIn app for iPhone and Android devices by searching for KCR College Radio. All right. So now that we got that plug out of the way, we can talk more about you. Okay.
Beautiful.
Perfect. And so, yeah, you know, you said you wanted to tour and everything. And I know you said right before you came here, too, You're working on a track, you know? Like, can we expect an EP, like an album on the way? Like, what's happening next, man?
Probably not. I'm just trying to bust out some tracks. I was working on this remix of a Taylor Swift song.
Which
one? That should be interesting.
Is it one of your new ones?
Caught your eye. You might be interested in that one.
I might be. Dang. Interesting. Very interesting.
I was talking to you originally.
Oh, wait. You were joking?
No. Let's keep going forward.
No, dude. No, I want to get back to that. I love Taylor Swift. Low key.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I won't tell too much about it. You can find it on the YouTube channel, though. My name is Yandi.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I will subscribe right now. Dang.
Oh, thank you.
Okay. And let's see. We don't have too much time left. And just to remind people again, where can we find you on social media?
You can find it at My Name is Yandi. It's Yandi. It's all one word.
Yeah.
Yep. You'll find it on Instagram, Twitter, everything. And you find the right one, you'll find the bio. It's all about the love, strength, and respect. You know, you'll find it, yeah.
What about SoundCloud? Where can we find you?
SoundCloud, there? Same thing. SoundCloud.com/MyNameIsYandi.
What about if people want to find you on Spotify?
Yandi, Yandi. You'll see my face up there.
Yeah, he has a few tracks on there.
Yeah, there's a few tracks that on Spotify that you can't really find anywhere else, which is pretty cool.
Exclusive. Okay, what about title?
Title? I don't know. I haven't really messed the title too much.
Yeah. It's good.
I don't want to like sound like cocky, but like you'll probably find me there.
Okay. Oh,
yeah.
Oh.
I mean, just with like the distribution service, you know, it's DistroKid. You know, you could pick to go on title and everything. So yeah.
That's awesome.
That's
okay.
About it.
We're gonna end the song on another track of you, one you do with Underhouse, and I think you know which one too. Actually, wait, real quick too. What happened to Gray White, man? Where is he at?
Oh, bro, he's just lurking.
He's lurking?
Oh, yeah.
Is he going to make an
appearance
anywhere.
Again? He didn't go anywhere. Don't worry.
All right, cool. Well, we're about to wrap things up. Thanks again for coming on, man.
Hey, thank you so much for having me.
All right. And you guys have a good one. I'll see you next week.
I'm feeling good. Yes, I'm feeling great.